If you have an ESP microcontroller in your home, don't miss this video. In the next few minutes, we will build a home automation unit with AI. We will not write any code at all. We will not even use a keyboard. Our unit will be able to control two bulbs and RGB strip, online and offline using our smartphone. We will be able to control them with RF remote controllers. And of course, the regular wall switches. Our devices will work with Alexa Echo devices. Also with Google Home. We will be able to set timers and schedules, receive notifications, and control the devices with our voice. We will add a digital sensor and a DHT to measure temperature and humidity, and link them with our devices to create an automation. All the software will be handled by CADIO platform. We just need to install CADIO firmware on the ESP and tell CADIO some information about our unit, and boom, job done. CADIO app is available on Google Play Store for Android devices and Apple App Store for iOS. We will download CADIO app and create an account by entering our email address and choosing a password and enter it twice. Now we have a CADIO account. We can now configure and link our units to it. To install CADIO firmware on ESP8266, we need to download the latest CADIO firmware and the ESP flash download tool. All these files can be downloaded from CADIO Download Center. Now we open the ESP flash download tool and select ESP8266. Then select the firmware file and set the address to 0x0. Set the flash mode to DIO and the speed to 40 MHz. Then select the port. And click erase to clear the ESP flash from any stored data. After erasing the flash, we click start to download the firmware on the ESP. And when downloading is done, we reset the ESP. And after seconds, CADIO firmware will be installed and the ESP will be ready for receiving the info file. We can build units with any architecture we want. In this unit, I have connected two relays to GPIO 4 and 5, two switches to GPIO 12 and 14, addressable RGB to GPIO 15, DHT to GPIO 10, and a digital sensor to GPIO 3. I'm using an IR sensor. I have connected also RF receiver module to GPIO 13. After CADIO firmware is installed on the ESP will create a Wi-Fi network for receiving the info file and configuration. We open the CADIO app and go to the configuration section. And connect the phone to the ESP Wi-Fi network. In seconds, the connection will establish and the info file page will appear. The info file page will create the info file based on our preferences, and all codes will be internally created with the power of AI. Now I will tell CADIO about my unit. For example, my relays module is active low, so I will set relays mode to active low. My unit has a 433 MHz RF receiver. So I will activate the 433 MHz and select the GPIO. In the devices table, I will add my devices and select their GPIOs, two on-off devices, RGB, DHT, and a sensor, and simply select their GPIOs. Then I will send the info file to the ESP. Now the configuration page appears. All we need to do is enter our home router Wi-Fi network details, so our unit can connect to the internet. After saving the configuration, the unit will start scanning networks, and connecting to our home network, and connect to the internet, and appear in the application interface. And now our unit is ready. Let's test it. With a simple click, we can control any device and turn it on or off. We can also use the switches to control the bulbs, and the new status is updated in the app. the switch will change the status of the device, whatever it was. We can change the RGB color. And adjust its brightness. We can use group orders to control all devices with a single click. The temperature and the humidity measured by the DHT and displayed. The IR sensor is working, and when I move my hand over it, it will activate, and its status is updated. A long press on any device will open the device page. From settings, we can rename the device. Select an icon. Add it to a group. Set a pin code and notifications. And set an auto turn off timer. Also, we can set a one-time timer to turn on or turn off the device at a specific time. And set a power schedule. We can link any device with temperature or humidity or sensors, and it will be turned on as long as the sensor is activated. For controlling our devices using an RF remote controller, we just need to assign a button for the device. And simply use it. We can control the devices with our voice. We just need to hold the mic icon and say, turn on light 1. Turn off light 1. To link your account with third-party services like Google Home and Alexa, you can find the linking instructions in the CADIO developer's docs. Just follow the steps, and your devices will work with Google Home and Alexa. Okay. Turn on light 1.
Got it. Turning the light 1 on.
Turn off light 1.
Okay. Turning the light 1 off.
Alexa. Turn on RGB lights.
Okay.
Turn off RGB lights.
Okay.
Our unit has two indicator LEDs. The red LED is the Wi-Fi LED. It keeps blinking while searching for the router Wi-Fi network, and lights permanently when connected to it. The blue LED lights permanently when the unit is connected to the internet, and keeps blinking when the unit is in the config mode. We also have a config button. Holding the config button for 10 seconds will apply a factory reset. Holding it for 3 seconds will make the unit enter the config mode, and clicking it will restart the unit. Anytime we want to change the unit configuration or the linked account, we simply hold the config button for 3 seconds, connect to ESP Wi-Fi network, and reconfigure it like we did before. The unit is automatically linked with the account that configured it. So if we want to link it with another account, we just simply hold the config button for 3 seconds and configure it while logging and using the other account. Our unit now has a trial license. The trial license is valid for 500 operating hours, and the trial license can be renewed for an unlimited number of times. To renew the trial license, we need to erase the firmware and reinstall it, and we can renew it as long as we want. The permanent license is available to purchase from license management page. The permanent license gives the unit a permanent permission to use CADIO system resources. The unit will never lose the permanent license, even the firmware is erased and reinstalled, or the linked account has changed, or even the unit architecture has changed. It will never lose the permanent license under any circumstances. We can log in using our account from an unlimited number of smartphones, and they will all be able to control the units and the devices at the same time. We can link an unlimited number of units to our account, and they will appear in the same interface. And let me tell you about my favorite feature. You can make the units communicate and send orders between themselves. For example, a sensor on the first unit can send orders to a bulb on the second unit even if the units are in different networks or in different places. Even if they are in different countries, oh my god. There are a lot of features to try in the upcoming videos. You must subscribe to our channel now. Reaching this point of the video means that you are so interested. You will love our content. Support us by like and share the video, bookmark our website, feel free to try CADIO. Feel free to contact us.